Hey everyone, it's Laz. As you can see, I'm feeling much better now. The cough is going away. So I created another troubleshooting lab for you. Now this is EIGRP troubleshooting lab. And it's a multi-part question. Now you're gonna see it when you get inside the lab, the different types of questions. Now I help you through the questions and I even answer some of the questions for you, right? But questions 4 and 5 are the most important ones. And once you get into the lab, you will see them. Now, my suggestion to you is not only to look at the video, obviously, of the lab. I mean, showing you the routing table and the topology table and telling you, hey, remember your K values, because K values are going to be a big thing here for you to figure this out. All right. My suggestion to you is to mimic the lab. You can mimic it in the packet tracer. That's fine. I will prefer that you guys start using GNSS3. All right. It's a lot better to do it, so you can be the same as me, but you can do it in the packet tracer to make it real quick, real easy. All right, so you can mimic it, so you can troubleshoot it, because you can't troubleshoot the video, right? Only what I showed you. But I showed you enough for you to figure out what's going on. So take your time, and I want you to think, because this is a single autonomous system, which is 200 EIGRP lab, right? Which I've answered pretty much. I've shown you questions 1, 2, and 3. 4 and 5 are the ones that you really need to say, okay, why is this happening? All right, and when you get into the lab, there's more explanations as I go through it and explain the lab. All right, so that said, wish you all the best. All right, if you like it, all right, please click like, all right, so I know that you liked it, but your feedback, always reply, give me your answers to what you think they are in the reply. And I'll be looking at them to see who's got the right answer. And always, don't go for the most difficult answer. This is towards the CCNA certification, okay? So don't get all crazy with CCNP topics. CCNA, all right? This is what you're gonna confront in your CCNA. Not this problem exactly, but something similar. Cool? I'll see you inside the lab. All right, welcome everybody. This is your Cisco CCNA EIGRP troubleshooting lab. Now, as you can see, we have two PCs, PC1 over here, PC2 over here. We're running a Class C address from the PC to the router, right, which is the gateway, okay? And then we have the same thing over here. This would be the 100, this is the 200, and we're running a Class A network all the way across. You can see 10.1.4, 8, 12, 16, 20, and 24. Now, if you were to open up, let's say router 1, okay, and you would do a show IP route, you can see you have connectivity all the way across. You can also check that by going inside the, you can't check it, but I'm just showing you that you can. PC1, here it is, all the way over here. All right, and I'll show you that we do have connectivity all the way across. I can just ping 192.168.200.1. And you're always gonna get your request timeout the first time. There's your reply, we'll do it again. So you can see you get all replies, okay? Because of the ARP, remember, this is Ethernet. So we're just gonna go around and ping 10.1.1.6, awesome, control C, up arrow, let's do 10, great, control C, up arrow, let's do 13, awesome, okay, let's do, let's see, we got 16, then we got 20, 21, let's do 21, we're good, and then we got 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, oops, up arrow, and 25. So we got connectivity all the way across. But here's the question. Here's the question. You have 5 of them. First one is, do a trace from PC1, because that is the actual command, trace. And then, you can't really do that. So I'm going to do it for you. You're going to do a trace from PC1 to PC2. Okay? So within this simulator, which is GNSS3, if I go to PC1 and I do a trace, I'm gonna go trace,
And I'm going to go 192.168.200.1. And you see it says 26, well, it goes to gateway, obviously, 26, 21, 27, and then finally to the PC. So it's going this way. The packet is going this way. So question, why does the packet take that path? Why? Okay. Does router one have a feasible successor? So if I were going to router one, oops, I don't have to do that. It's right here. Router one, boom. Does it have a feasible successor? And where we would look that up, we would look at the topology table. So show IP EIGRP topology. Okay. So do we have a feasible successor that goes to the 200.network? I'm showing you the screen here. Yes or no. Okay, yes or no. So you're going to tell me. I'm not going to point it out to you. All right. One of the things that you do want to look at is P because it's passive, which is good. But remember your K values. Remember your K values. So this is the topology table for router one. All right. Is there a feasible successor for the 192.168.200.0 network? And if it is, which is that feasible successor? Now, if you look at the routing table, show IP route. Okay. You see that for the 200 network, we have only one entry, okay? But if you look at the topology, table, that is not true, okay? That is not true. And it will make sense because we got two ways of going. But it chose to go this way. It chose to go this way. So I don't need to show you now for the following one. Which is, why does R1 have a feasible successor? I mean, there could be many reasons. You tell me. These are all fast Ethernet interfaces. They're all 100 megabits per second, right? So why does it have a feasible successor? And what command can you use to load balance and make the feasible successor a part of the routing table? So there is a command within EIGRP that you can actually use, and you can load balance, all right, across both links. But for some reason, it doesn't, at the moment, the packet doesn't want to go this way, okay? It doesn't. It's going this way. And really, it's like, well, why? I mean, they're both the same bandwidth. And I'll give you a clue. That's one of the things you need to look at, which is the K values. The K values. Okay? So think on this. Think on this. And again, I've shown you the topology table. I've shown you the routing table. I did the tracer for you, or the trace, okay, for you, that is choosing to go this way. And there's a reason for that. All right? So to answer this question, you already saw it. You already saw this. You know this. Okay. I did this for you. The question is, okay, what is that command that you can use to load balance and then make that feasible successor part of the routing table? But why does router one have a feasible successor when they're all fast Ethernet interfaces? Why is that? Okay. See what you can come up with. You can duplicate the lab in the packet tracer. If you have GNS3, you can duplicate it in GNS3. But you looked already at enough stuff where you saw the routing table, you saw the topology table. We are running EIGRP 200 on all these routers. All right, it's a single autonomous system. So it shouldn't be, nothing to do with the routing protocol itself. But within the routing protocol, for question number 5, is where you need to look for that answer. There is a command in there that you can go ahead and load balance. Find out what that is.